repeatedly said that you believe initial coin offering tokens are securities, but right here it's sounding like you're acknowledging that Ether transitioned from what would have been a security into a commodity once the network was adequately decentralized. Can you clarify when a token is sufficiently decentralized to no longer be a security in your view?
I thank you for that. And digging back to an article from 3 years ago, I was honored to study and research these issues at MIT. And what I was commenting on then was a process that the SEC was going forward on. And I think then head of corporate finance was talking about in that time frame. And so without going into any one token, what I think the core test is, and it's the test the Supreme Court has taken up numerous times with a broad brush, are you raising money from others and the investing public anticipating profits based upon the efforts in some collective group of individuals? That's central test. It's called the Howey test. There's
somebody called John Deaton. What the hell is he smoking? Because it can't be legal. That's a Jeremy Hogan. What is going on, blockchain monkeys? Eagle here, like to thank you for coming to my jungle. But first of all, I am no financial advisor whatsoever, nor am I professional in blockchain technology. But there is one thing that I absolutely will do, and that's give my opinion. So we got to get to it. We got so much slanging right to Twitter. What is Gary Gensler talking about? In Bank of America, we have watched the tables turn. Take a listen. We have crypto law. Why are so many XRP holders so angry at the SEC? Here is the story. You're going to want to take a look at this. I was checking it out, and there is a timeline of each and every single event that happened that led up to the SEC lawsuit with Jay Clayton and everything all on there. It is amazing. Take a look at that. And we have here, Gary, you're so obvious, XRP. If you haven't had a chance, check this out. This is Tom Emmer. He rips a hole into Gary on being accountable for his leadership and how it could devastate America and the crypto investors. You see, they're already moving over to Malta's and other areas. It is just nuts. But he goes ham on Gary. And Gary just, like, it's weird to watch because you just know he's, like, lying right to your face. You know what I'm saying? And a huge shout out to Alex. Alex is straight fire. She terrorizes the clubhouse. I mean, a wealth of information. Check her out on Twitter at AlexDGK07. But as far as the XRPL airdrops, she's on top of them, like flies on shit. Okay, now they are. they are continuing to allow people to get an airdrop after this one. If you set it before the 60K, then you can be a part of the next drop. So check that out. And guys, ladies, gentlemen, get your trust lines in order. Okay, now we have Crypto Cali. Check her out too. NFTs on Smash right now. She has a store off the chain. I got one of her hoodies. It's a F Fiat with an XRP logo on there. So check that out. Now, come on down here because it doesn't stop. Why would it? Okay. Now, this is where the XRP community comes into play. I put a question here. It says, are the direct instructions on claiming Songbird when held on your XRP and Zum wallet? And they just attacked with answers. So huge shout out to them. And another huge shout out to Proton. ADA is now available on there. The addition of the mainnet Cardano on Proton means you can send and receive ADA using the Proton swap bridge, unlocking swapping for another top five cryptocurrency without the gas fees of other blockchains. So huge shout out to them for that as they are innovating and moving forward. And just to keep this fresh, ladies and gentlemen, in front of your face, don't ever forget the Fed had two presidents quit yesterday because of how damning the evidence of their insider trading was. And Gensler doesn't want you to get 4% on your crypto savings account. You are about to experience the ride of your life. Do you understand what type of rocket you're on? What type of rocket you've boarded? I hope you got your moon boots ready. You know what I'm saying? Weed's plentiful, okay? AC is up and the Wi-Fi is on. Let's go, okay? Now, so a huge shout out to Crypto for Life. I got goosebumps listening to the show today. Thank you, fellas, for spitting major game. Me and C. Will have did a video interview on Algorand and Opulus. If you haven't had a chance to check that out, that's on the videos. Now, clean your nose and sniff this. Are you ready? Let me help you understand what the future of banking looks like. XRP is a standard. Let go. Look at this here, ladies and gentlemen. Shaping the future of cross-border payments, the world is converging on a new global standard, ISO 222, the de facto global data standard for modern payments. To help enable this next step in global interoperability and meet the evolving needs of customers, Ripple is now part of the ISO 222 standard.
ISO, baby, that's banks and their patents.
It's right in front of your face, okay? You have your October 4th Federal Reserve Board announces the Reserve Banks will adopt a new message format for the Fedwire Fund Service and invites public comment on proposal to expedite adoption. Do they need to hurry it up or something? Is that like what they're saying here? Huh? Are they trying to speed things up right now? The Federal Reserve Board on Monday announced that its Federal Reserve Banks will adopt ISO 222 message format for Fedwire Fund Service. The change will allow for enhanced efficiency of both domestic and cross-border payments. Who's taking care of that? I'm going to leave that there on my Twitter, okay? Who is taking care of that? Now, we can't ignore this either. We can't ignore SBI and what they're doing over there. SBI Group launched a $75 million digital asset venture fund. SBI Group, along with Signum and Azimut Group, has launched $75 million digital asset venture fund that will help startups evolve in the DeFi, DLT, and regulatory technology space with pre-Series A and Series A funding. What type of castle are they building here? Because when you talk about SBI, I can only think of Ripple. San Francisco-based payments technology company Ripple has partnered with SBI Remit, Japan's largest money transfer provider, mobile payment service coins.ph, and digital asset exchange platform SBI VC Trade to use XRP for remittances between Japan and the Philippines, according to a company statement. How much cream do you need in your coffee? Because isn't this sweet enough? And you still need more cream, don't you? I know, I understand, because I do too. But it's right in front of your face, ladies and gentlemen. How could you not be frothy? How could your tongue and your mouth not be salivating with ah? And coming in from Jeremy Hogan, congratulations to Jeremy Deaton and XRP holders. You now have an official voice in the Rippleverse SEC case. It is going down, ladies and gentlemen. And this is the reason why I said somebody called John Deaton. What the hell are they smoking? And Jeanette Carlo coming in hot. She says, not illegal to purchase XRP in the USA. Hands over to face. Take a listen.
Last one in the same space, Ripple, you say you like it.
A flush and then maybe reversal, or we have to get back over 250. We're smack dab in the middle in weak momentum. And right now, unless you have deep pockets, I would keep watching, but stand aside.
On a tennis court, they call that no man's land. You don't want to be there. Last one in the same space, Ripple, you say you like it, XRP, but isn't it illegal for U.S. investors right now? How do you buy that?
There are ways, but you kind of have to go through multiple steps. But I would try to find that out. Obviously, we don't have time for me to tell you now. But I'm very interested in it. Actually, they just announced today that they're putting about $250 million into looking into NFTs, how they can use their ledgers for doing that, things like house deeds and car titles, etc. And so it's illegal, but I think that
it is not illegal. So before I let you go, we have Bank of America bullish on Bitcoin, says crypto market too large to ignore. Huh? Bank of America said that? Huh? Wall Street banking giant Bank of America called blockchain the most exciting new market in years in a new research report. What did us as blockchain monkeys say over a year ago? See, we came here before you did, okay? We welcomed the doors to you people a long time ago, and now you want to come in. Because if I can remember correctly, let me take a look back. So we have here, Bank of America is worried about the threat of cryptocurrency to its business. And this was coming in what year? Oh, 2018, was it not? It's just a little peculiar to me when I see over here R3. Yes, R3 is an enterprise software company founded in 2015. Well, if it was founded in 2015 and Bank of America was so scared about cryptocurrencies in 2018, Why did you become a shareholder back then? Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, HSBC, Barclays, ING. Ladies and gentlemen, you got to follow the money. Don't get a like, comment, and subscribe. And we will all see each other on the moon.
Because it's the standard in this bitch. SRP. I went to YouTube University, and now they mocking me, with no degree, we saying by the swift, keep it walking, respecting elders in these bushes, Bitcoin is talking.